Okay, so last time I recorded for an entire hour, giving the wrong decimal place for the golden ratio. It's actually 1.618, and in fact, it's an irrational number. I believe now it's like feet, just like pi, is 3.14159, and in fact can be infinitely, and has been tried to find to infinitely be repeated to find a pattern, but apparently none exist. So far, that is the golden ratio, the golden number. It's called a ratio because of its little it being a sequence. So I was a little unprepared last time. I'm hopefully a little more prepared this time to talk about the Fibonacci sequence. And in fact, the Fibonacci sequence, or Fibonacci numbers, a series of numbers, is very intimately connected with the golden ratio. And it's connected to get right to the point, to do something I never do, because the act of forming successively larger rectangles using the golden ratio as your guide will, using the width and lengths of those successive rectangles, lead ultimately to the convergence of 1.68. And the golden ratio and these Fibonacci numbers are what will inform how we draw those rectangles. And yesterday I drew the Osaka's great wave, a little picture of it. And I drew that because apparently if I would have drawn it a little more accurately, its dimensions are informed by the rectangles that are created by the Fibonacci numbers. So going back to this drawing here I did, I wanted to point out the other day that the Twitter lightly trace it and then slowly get more and more bold. Get more courageous. Okay, so the Twitter logo will look something like this. And it was fascinating when I read this. So we're gonna start like right here and we're just gonna trace to about right here. Touch the bottom. Okay. And then it does. Let me zoom in real quick. Oh. Too many clicks. And I believe even the beak itself is actually a size circle, and we're gonna try to transpose it. So maybe I could. Oh wow, look, that almost fits perfectly inside. So I believe what happened was it goes like I'm gonna use my guitar pick to inform it. Informant form. I'm using that word. This feels like one of those draw by numbers things, but you know, I'll just be a little more quick than I usually am. Okay, and the last one, I guess I'll wait. So, the actual head of the bird, I will embolden. It stops right there. So for this top one, this defines the exactly how to do this, but there is, in fact, a fourth circle right there, and that's how this one knows when to stop. Right there, kind of. Not we take our nice blue pen. And we, let's trace this out. So you get the idea, and fill this in here with our blue marker. Of course, it's going to be green where it meets the yellow. Okay, so how the heck did that happen? So the Fibonacci sequence is simply that's the wrong symbol. It's roughly equal to the golden ratio. It's intimately connected. And it is starting with zero and incrementing to one. That's the foundation of it. You simply get the next number in the sequence. 0 and 1 is 1. 1 and 1 is 2, and so on. 3. 2 and 3 is 5. And 8. 5 and 8 is 13. 8 and 13 is 21. 13 is, and 21 is 30-something. Something interesting about this is that how it converges. So if you notice these, so 1 and 1, that forms a rectangle. In the first rectangle, which is 1.64. 1, 8, and depending on how many iterations we do, it'll keep on going. Go on until I finally reach that 8, that infinity I wanted to put right there. So let's do a couple, and I'll show you. So we want to, the thing is length divided by width. So the first one, because we started off with a square, and then we got another one, 0 and 1 gives us 1, so that's how we got the second one. And from there on, satisfaction, because really it's arbitrary. The point at which we stop is arbitrary, and up to the point that our instruments can calculate that, because it will go on infinitely. So the weird part about that is that we never actually arrive at feet. We never have to pay the fee. Just working on my dad jokes here, guys. And then, of course, we can go on until it approximates V. So let's see. Fibonacci sequence, and that one here are apparently the most aesthetically pleasing. Empirically, you can show people things that are based and derived on, and there's tons of art out there if you just search golden ratio advertisements or logos. You'll see the Apple logo is I like the idea of successive approximation, because that's what I do when I trace. I think I just successively approximate it. Just do it until it looks right. But anyways, that's apparently where the Apple logo gets it from, and it's all these little circles and like this is part of a much bigger circle. And of course these right here and all these diameters of these circles are arrived at by using circles with proportions in the ratio of feet. So cool. I think the Toyota logo, obviously Twitter, Apple, yeah, there's lots. So obviously the Egyptians understood this, and the Greeks, I'm sure, got it from the Egyptians primarily. And interestingly, even rabbit populations were modeled on this, can be quite accurately modeled on it. You would think they would, you know, just really, really, what's the word I'm thinking of? Like an elementary, a very crude estimation of what rabbits might do would be something like an exponential growth. 2, 4, 8, 16, 32. But that doesn't take into account that life actually dies. But what would is actually, let's see, 1, 2, what was it, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21. So apparently this does used it. So many artists, I talked about Da Vinci and Michelangelo and the origin. So it was actually like 2,500 years ago for the actual name. Fee. I'm trying to read this and consolidate it for you guys. So fee is an irrational number. Its digits carry on forever and ever, infinitely. Infinitely, infinitely. By the way, go check out Greasius ASMR. I believe it's spelled like that. He's got a really cool video of him just outlining an infinity symbol. It's mesmerizing. So if I look away, I'm sure I'll start to make this very interesting. So, well, it's funny how it started drifting. about 2,500 years ago. Down the rabbit hole. But it's essentially how plants grow. Let me see if I can. Well, I couldn't really find anything about that. that circle and inscribed it inside a square so that the sides of the circle tangentially touch exactly one point on the edge of this square. So if you just inscribe, pretend each square is like a quarter section of the circle, and this one, the section of the circle, the arc, would get progressively larger. So now five, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As you can see, plants, of course, are confined by space. Their ability to take up space is what inhibits, obviously, much of their growth. So now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. I had it too many. We'll just make this one straight. And then it just goes on. And, it's, just endless bifurcation to the point that it's inhibited by physical causes, of course. So there's a tendency for exponential growth. But I think the Fibonacci sequence, the most interesting thing about it is that it appears to be, just like it appears to, for some reason, manifest in the optimal, aesthetically pleasing triangle. It appears that it's following this pattern. Plants are most optimally spread out among their leaves to absorb and not infringe upon each other's leaves. The amount of sunlight that they can absorb. Of course, if you had endless exponential growth, you might have the tree fighting with itself over sunlight. And, of course, that wouldn't be good. So I'm just draw some leaves in here using the techniques from my bonsai artist. Scribble to make the shadows under the leaves, under the branches. Anyways, alright guys, I hope you learned something. I really enjoy doing these mathematical videos. I probably should have done more patron rubbing. I really like the sound of that. Sean, Kieran Cox, Debbie, Petrell, Chester, Dylan, Alexander Arroyo, Cameron, Katie McHale, Simon Smith, Ella Gregory, Potato Lunch, and Andy. Thank you guys so much. Hope you all sleep well, enjoy your evening, and as always, have a better night.